and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we'll be showing you how to paint the Scriptor Mortis from the Arena of Shades box set up to battle ready. Now, before we begin, we need to give it an undercoat. As you can see here, we've done grey sear spray, and we've done a sub-assembly for ease of painting. For our first colour, though, we'll be using Nighthaunt Gloom, thinned down with Larmian Medium for our spectral trails. So we're going to just dip into the pot, and we're going to get one part Larmian Medium, and we're going to wash our brush off and dry it off. Then we're going to get one part Nighthaunt Gloom, and then we're just going to mix it in well. So it's just slightly thinned down. Get our brush to a lovely point, and then we can start applying it to our trails. So we're going to avoid any light areas, such as that bone column there. And continue around. We're going to stop just around this bit around here. Now that our Nighthaunt Gloom is now dry, we can move on to the rest of our base coats. For this, we'll be using Iron Rex Skin for the Ghoulish skin, Galvorback Red for the red details, and for our metalwork, we'll be using Castellax Bronze. So let's get on with that Iron Rex Skin. So we're just going to dip into the pot and make sure that the tip of our brush is nice and pointy, and then we can start applying it to the skin. So we're just going to make sure that we don't get any of that Nighthaunt Gloom. We're going to slowly blend into it, and you find if your paint's a little bit too thick for that, just thin it down with a little bit of water. Now that our Iron Rack flesh is now dry, we can move on to that Galvorback Red. We're going to use it on the quill feather, and don't forget to do it on the book cover on the sub-assembly. Now that our Galvorback Red is done on the quill and the book, we can move on to the metalwork. For this, we'll be using Castellax Bronze, and we'll be using it on the lantern, the quill nib, the candelabra, and the book edges. With our Castellax Bronze now dry, our first base coats are complete. Now we can finish off with our last base coat, and first we'll be using Apothecary White for the bone lectern. So we're going to just dip into the pot and make sure that it's nice and mixed on the palette. You may find that you want a little touch more, so it's just enough for your brush to be full. And now we can start applying it to that lectern. So we just want to get it all over this bony area and along down the bone spine towards the floor. Make sure you don't get it on any of those ghostly trails. Now that our Apothecary White is now finished, we can move on to our last base coats. For these, I'll be using a Shabti Bone for the candles in the pages, Corvus Black for the smoky details, and Corax White for the lantern's spooky smoke. So let's get on with our Shabti Bone. So we're going to dip into the pot and pop it down on our palette, and we're going to thin it down just a little touch, just so it's a little bit smoother, and get our brush to a point, and we can start applying it to those candles. And we just want to make sure that we cover all the candle, avoiding the flame on the top. You may find that you need another layer, just in case that's a little bit too thin. Now that's dry, we can move on to the Corvus Black, and we're going to be using that on the details of the hair. Also use it on the tip of the feather, and we're going to use it on the smoke towards the bottom where that candle's gone out. And now that is dry, we can move on to some Corax White, and we're going to use this on the smoky trails. And what we're going to do is just highlight the areas that are raised, just so we get a little bit more depth for our next stages. Now that our base coats are now finished, we can move on to our next steps. For these, we'll be using some contrasts and some shades, and first off we'll be using some Pterodon Turquoise thinned down with contrast medium. So we're just going to take one part, and two parts contrast medium, and pop that on the palette. I'm going to wash our brush off, I'm going to dry it off, and then we're going to take one part Pterodon Turquoise, just to mix that in. So we're just thinning it down slightly. I'm getting our brush to a lovely point, and then we can start applying it to our ghostly trails. And make sure you don't get it on any candles or the bone lectern, and make sure you don't get it onto the ghoulish skin too much. Now that our contrast is now dry, we can move on to our shades. For these, we'll be using Agraxa's shade and Seraphim Sepia thinned down with Lamia Medium, and then None All straight from the pot. So let's get on with our Agrax Earth shade. So we're going to just take one part, and then two parts Lamia Medium. We're going to wash off our brush and dry it. And then we're going to take one part Agrax Earth shade, and we're going to mix it up. So we just want like a nice thin consistency. Get a little point to our brush, and then we're going to start putting it on the ghoulish skin. So we're going to just put it in the recesses between the bony bits, so it just gets nice and dirty and kind of creepy. Now that our Agrax Earth shade is now dry, we can move on to our Seraphim Sepia. We'll be using a mix of one part Seraphim Sepia to one part Lamia Medium, and we're going to apply that on the candles and the pages of the book. And remember, you can put a few on the pages of the book to give it a nice dirty and worn look. Now that Seraphim Sepia is now dry, we can move on to the Nun Oil, and we'll be using this to shade the lantern metalwork and any of the candelabra metalwork, the quill point, and then any parts of the feather as well. Now that our shades are dry, we're going to move on to some Tesseract Glow. We're going to be applying this to the lantern spooky smoke and candle flames. So we're just going to get a little bit onto our brush, and then we're going to immediately apply it to the smoke area. Even though this is a technical paint, it does work very similar to a shade or a contrast. Now that our Tesseract Glow is now dry, we can finish the model off by doing some basing. This will be using a Grelin Badlands, and we'll be using our trusty texture tool for this. So we're just going to scoop it out the top of the pot. Make sure we get a good amount. I'm going to use the wide part of the texture tool. And then we can start applying it to the base. Now remember, it may take a little bit of time, around an hour, for it to dry. I'm going to use the other end of the texture tool to make sure that we don't get it onto the cloak or any bits touching the base. And remember to paint the rim and the model in the same colours to match the rest of your army. Now that our base is done, you can see that I have glued the book down to the rest of our Scriptor Mortis. With the texture now dry and the rim of the base painted, our Scriptor Mortis is now battle ready, and you better pray he doesn't write your name into this book of death. Remember to keep your base coats nice and smooth, and don't overload your brush when using shades and contrasts. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoy painting your own Scriptor Mortis, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye!